हेलो टू ऑल ऑफ यू स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू मेक अ स्मॉल डेरिवेशन हियर व्हिच इज़ फ्रॉम द आर्टिकल 1.5.2 फ्रॉम पेज नंबर 8 ऑफ आवर टेक्स्ट बुक। सो एज वी नो दैट एवरी सब्सटेंस इट इज़ एसोशिएटेड विद अ पर्टिकुलर मोलार मास एंड डेंसिटी, and this density of the substance it is same as the density of the unit cell, and this unit cell it is in turn associated with this edge length. So it is logical to find out the relationship between the molar mass, density of the substance and the edge length of the unit cell. So today we are going to find out the relationship between molar mass, density of the substance and the edge length of the unit cell, that is we call it as unit cell edge length A. Now taking this formula into the mind, we have to find out the mass of the unit cell and then we will find the volume of the unit cell. Let us move further. Now let us first find volume of the unit cell. It will be easy. Now if you look at this unit cell, this is the edge of the unit cell and it is A. So what is the volume of the unit cell? Volume of the unit cell is equal to A multiplied by A multiplied by A. All the edges they are same, edge length is same because this is a cube. So the volume of the unit cell it will be A into A into A, that is A cube. So we have found the expression for volume of the unit cell, that is A cube. Now let us find out the mass of the unit cell. The mass of the unit cell it is nothing but the mass of all these atoms in the unit cell. And what is the total mass of all these atoms? It is equal to the, if we suppose that the mass of the one atom is m and there are total of n atoms, ya thikani jar ek atom cha mass jar m asel ani ya unit cell madhe jar total n atom astil tar ya unit cell cha total mass ka asel. So the total mass will be of the unit cell will be mass of one atom multiplied by total of n atoms. So it will be equal to m into n. So mass of the unit cell it is actually equal to m into n, that is mass of one atom multiplied by total of n atoms. Now again we have the formula density of the unit cell, it is equal to the mass of unit cell upon volume of unit cell. We have found the mass of unit cell is equal to m into n and the volume of unit cell is equal to A cube. Now about the molar mass. Now from our knowledge we know that molar mass of a substance is given by the formula. Molar mass is equal to mass of one particle multiplied by number of particles per mole. Now the per mole, each mole contains Avogadro number of particles. So the molar mass it is equal to mass of one particle multiplied by Avogadro number. We have learned this in 11th standard. So keeping this in mind, from this expression, if you know the molar mass, we can say that mass of one particle it is equal to this mass divided by this molar mass divided by Avogadro number. So this is again a derived formula. Mass of one particle or mass of one atom is equal to molar mass divided by Avogadro number. Now again we know that the density is equal to mass of one particle multiplied by n upon a cube. Now if m is equal to m upon n a, if we substitute m for m upon n a, here substituting this m, we get n into m divided by a cube into n a, that is Avogadro number. So if we know the number of atoms in the unit cell or number of particles in the unit cell, if we know the number of particles, if we know the molar mass, if we know the edge length, we can find out the density of the substance. So this expression, it gives the relationship between the density of the substance, molar mass and edge length of the unit cell.